Hey, team kids, Mr. Steve, we're getting ready to only have virtual lessons for a little while just because of this coronavirus. So it's a little bit of a spread in our community, and we just want to keep everybody safe. So we'll be starting virtual lessons only, actually beginning today. And we'll let you know well in advance when we're going to start back meeting in person. But we just want to let you know how much we love you and we miss you. And we thought we would do kind of a year in review lesson and see some of the highlights from all year long. And I wanted to give Miss Lacey and Miss Jania a chance to talk about some of their favorite lessons. So let's start. Ladies, who wants to go first?
I'll go first. So it can be me. Let's see. Mr. Steve asked me my favorite lesson. Oh my gosh, I have so many. But I think I want to talk just a bit about the creation lesson, because I remember when I first taught that lesson with y'all, and we divided that all the days up around the room, and we put numbers on the floor, and then you rotated around to 1, 2, 3, all the different days. And I'm so amazed at just how well you remembered. And it didn't matter what number you ended up on when we moved around, you still remembered what God created on that day. And to me, that is just amazing, because you know what? That tells me that you're listening. And the more we listen, then the more we're going to understand what it is that God wants for us. And so I'm just thankful for creation. I look outside, I can see out my window right now in my kitchen, and I can see trees. And although the leaves are gone, I get so excited. And I just, you know, it's a wonder to me that God created all of that, and that He created us too. And you know, I almost want to say, kind of saved the best thing for last. You know, he created you, he created me, he created Mr. Steve and Miss Lacey, but then you know what? He rested and he sat back and he just looked at all that he had done. And to me, that's, I guess, my favorite part.
All right, great. Hey, Miss Lacey, how are you today?
Hey, how are you?
I'm great. What's your favorite lesson?
One of the lessons that sticks out to me is when I handed out the coins to all of you kids, and we took a coin, and some of you I gave a bunch of coins to, and then on one of you I just gave one coin, and we talked about the widow's gift, and we talked about all the rich man, and just talked about giving and how we give and how our hearts are prepared for giving. And you know, those rich men, they gave a lot of money, but it wasn't what Jesus asked of them. They didn't have that right heart. But that one widow, she only gave one coin compared to all the others, but Jesus found favor in her and her gift, because she really gave from the heart. And as we left, or as we're still in this season of giving, that's what kind of stuck out to me is, let's not let our giving to each other and our families and people in need, let's not let it stop here. Let's let it continue throughout the year. Look for ways we can help each other and encourage each other. And let's have that widow's heart and ultimately the heart of Jesus as we try to find ways to help others.
Wow, that's great, ladies. Thank you for sharing with that. You know, one of my favorite lessons was the lesson of the Ten Commandments, because all the kids could remember all those symbols to help them remember the Ten Commandments. And, you know, I think that carried on for a long time. I mean, during game time, we'd have a game where they just have to spontaneously quote a commandment based on the symbol, or give the symbol based on the commandment. So that's one of my favorites. But you know, I was thinking back in March, we had a lesson on the Lord's Supper. We were looking at the ordinances, and the kids' expressions when we passed around the piece of bread and everybody had to break off a piece, and they were all a little bit grossed out because everybody was touching the bread, right? And they had to think about, you know, back in the day, that's how the Lord's Supper was spread. It was a piece of bread, and they passed it around. And when we talked about sharing the cup, they were a little bit grossed out about that, too. So that led us to the very first video, which was on the ordinance of baptism. And Miss Jania did a great job with that, and that's going to be one of the highlights that you'll see in the video. Ladies, do y'all have a recorded video lesson that stands out in your mind?
Hey, Mr. Steve. I remember, because I got a lot of comments about this one, and you know, sometimes when I sit down and I study my teen kid lessons, what's in the book for me to teach and what I actually say kind of isn't the same thing. Sometimes I think God just lets me know what I need to do and gives me some little activities to do. And I did this one video and this one lesson that really stood out to me, because you can carry this one with you each and every day. And I had two bags, and on one of the bags, it was very decorated and really pretty, and I decorated it with ribbons and made it really cute on the outside. And on the other bag was kind of greasy and dirty, and actually got it at the garbage can. And then we talked about how God doesn't look at the outside of us. He looks at the inside, because he's only really concerned with our hearts. And because that's how we get to know him. And I loved that one, because if you remember, inside that beautiful bag was like a rotten banana and like some tuna and something really gross. But inside the one that looked so yucky, he had all kinds of little baby cakes and yummy stuff like that. And so I just, that's one that kind of sticks out to me.
Oh, good job, Mr. Nia. I remember that lesson, because actually part of that lesson made our highlight film. All right, Miss Lacey, what about you? Do you remember any of the recorded lessons that stick out?
Well, one of the most fun that we had recording was Philip and the Traveler. We tried to set it up like the like an Imaginex toy review, and Mr. Josh had way too much fun just setting that up and preparing that and helping me to get the message out to you guys. But in that lesson, we saw Philip. He was traveling, and he saw this traveler on the side of the road, and he actually stopped and he took time. And the guy was confused about what he was reading. He was trying to read the Bible, but he just wasn't understanding that. And I guess to me, that really hit home, because it, when you first pick up the Bible, it really just doesn't make sense. But you know, after day and years after years of reading and studying and obeying God's word and praying to him, you know, one day it just finally clicks. And that, I think that's really what happened with that traveler, is it just clicked that one day. And that's what I pray for you guys, is sometimes we go through all these lessons, and I hope they build off one of each other and just really helps you understand who Jesus really is, and what he means to you, and how you can apply him to your daily life.
Oh, that's great. You know, one of my favorite video sections was, I had a gift in my lesson and talked about how, you know, a gift is really no good until somebody receives the gift. Mm. And around Christmas time, we like to say that Jesus is the greatest gift of all, and all Christian believers really believe that. But to be honest, that gift is not worth anything until somebody receives the gift. And we can say that, for God so loved the world that he sent his only son, that whosoever believes should not perish, but have everlasting life. The receive is the most important part. The believing is the most important part, because, I mean, you think about it. Kids, you gave your parents a gift at Christmas. I think you did. How would you feel if they didn't take it? And that's probably how God feels every time somebody rejects Jesus as their Savior. So that's one of my favorite video sections. And you'll see that in the video mashup here in a little bit. All right. Thank you, ladies. We'll get this mashup started.
There's a mashup on here. And Brother John will talk about how wonderful the decision is that you have made. And he will have you to stand. And usually he'll have you to squat so he didn't make anybody fall. And then he will have you hold you on those so you don't get choked. And then he'll say some words, and then he will dunk you in the water. And then he'll bring you back up the water. And you know why? Because this represents the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
And that's what I want you to get out of today's lesson, is the Bible is true. The Bible never changes. The Bible is just the same as it was then, as it was now. The Bible is without error. The Bible, people have been trying to prove this Bible wrong ever since it was written. But guys, they can't.
They just can't do it. And lastly, the Bible lasts forever. The Bible is eternal. Everything that they went through, those Israelites, it's in here to help us to go through trials and tribulations that we go through today. And it can always be trusted. We can always trust what God put in here, and He says it's true.
All right, Team Blue, glad you are back with us at Team Kid. I've been missing you. You know what, Team Blue, can you look and see how many bandanas I've got? You know why I've only got two blue bandanas? Because all the Team Blue kids, I think, took them home. It's him. Miraculously, God saved His people from slavery, led them out of Egypt, and Moses was their on-earth leader, and there's some interesting things. Team Red, just for you, the Bible's, this Bible story that we're going to have today is going to help you know more about God and Jesus and the Holy Spirit. And for you Team Yellow kids, this Bible story is about God telling us about Himself. He's really telling us how great He is. And then for you Team Blue, this story is not just about God, not just about how great He is, but it also gives us a glimpse into His plan of salvation.
This gift that I had, right? This big gift. One thing that you need to know about gifts is somebody can give a gift, but it has to be taken for it to truly be a gift. So if I give you a gift, if I give you a present, let's say, the only way that you benefit from that gift or that present is if you take it.
Way to go. All you have to do is simply bow your head and ask Him. That's all He wants us to do. Or use your Bible. These are our directions. Everything we need to know, every decision that we need to make, guys, we can find the answers right here.
And taught the Ethiopian man about Jesus. After understanding and believing that Jesus is the Son of God, the man became a follower of Jesus and wanted to be baptized.
And again, it kind of spreads out, but it didn't really get everybody that he knew. And old Apollo, he when he heard that word, right? When he heard that word from Aquila and Priscilla that taught him about Jesus and the real Jesus. You know, I think the Holy Spirit kind of come in his life. And when it did, I want you to look what happened. When the Holy Spirit started coming into Paul's life, into Apollo's life, notice how all that stuff that he was telling him about the good news, notice how it just started spreading and spread.
God never looks on the outside. He doesn't judge us based on the color of our skin, what school we go to, the kind of clothes we wear, the people we hang out with, we're the cool kids or not the cool kids, what race we are. He doesn't look at the outside. He looks at our heart. You know, that's what I want for you too. I want you to stop looking on the outside. Don't judge those books or those people on their covers. I want you to start looking on the inside.
Sometimes God doesn't answer our prayers right away.
Hey guys, I'm Alicia, and I just wanted to tell y'all about a time in my life that I prayed for something and God answered it in His perfect timing.
We heard about somebody that the Lord answered immediately. We heard that a time where it took a long time for Him to answer. And then we heard a testimony that He's still working through that person and through the process. And that's what I want you to see, that the Lord God, He's holy and He's sovereign, and He has everything under control. Even though we don't feel sometimes that we have everything under control, that's what we have to hang on to, is that He knows what's best for us. Jeremiah 29:11, His plans are good. His plans are to prosper us. And sometimes we might have to change our plans to what His plans are for us.
What is the church?
What is a church?
What is the church?
What's a church?
It's a church.
Is the church a building?
No.
Can the church do things to show other people God's love? Well, not if the church is just this building. These walls and these tables can't do anything except
sit here. So the church is the people.
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 You are the church.
Your teen kid lesson that we did way back at the very beginning when we were talking about creation. You know, before God made the sun and God made the moon and God made the stars, there still was light. Jesus was the light. And if you remember, before all of that, we had all three of God's parts with us because they've been here with us from the very beginning. We had God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, and if you'll remember, we said they were all three in one. So you see, the Holy Spirit, when we ask Jesus to come into our hearts, the Holy Spirit comes inside of us and he fills us with his life. And so when you become a believer, God's light becomes a part of you. And just like our Bible verse said, it's our job to spread that light to other people. So I'll take my light, and when I tell someone about Jesus, I'm going to spread it. And then Miss Lacey becomes a believer. She has the Holy Spirit light inside of her, and she spreads the news too. And she spread it with Mr. Steve.
And teen kids, once you become a believer, then you spread the light to the whole world.
I appointed you to go and produce fruit, and that your fruit should remain. So whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give to you. This is what I command you. Love one another.
Boys and girls, I've got a special guest with us today, Mr. Kerry Clark. He knows a lot about trees, and I thought since John chapter 15, verse 2, talked about pruning trees, we might ask a tree expert. Mr. Kerry, why would somebody, if they looked at a perfectly healthy looking fruit tree, want to cut part of it off?
There's several reasons somebody might want to cut part of the tree off. It's called pruning.
So I just wanted to take a minute and just thank you, Miss Tracy, for letting us come out to your farm today. And Team Kid, I hope that what you got from this lesson is God provides for us. God sustains us. He has plans for us. And I just pray that we can trust him in that fact. Miss Tracy told this wonderful story about how he took care of those horses and sustained him. And boys and girls, he does that for you too. We just have to hold on to those promises. Stay close to our Bibles. Love the Lord. Keep in step with him in prayer time, and just keep seeking him in all that we think, say, and do.
Trust the Bible. And I think by now you're starting to understand that we can. And today we want to look at how the Bible testifies to what is true and that it's the infallible Word of God. Now, let's talk about that word that I just said, infallible. The root word in there is fall or fail. And the Bible cannot fall. It will not fall. It cannot fail. It will stand the test of time. It is true forever. It was true back when the different men of the Bible, different men wrote the Bible, inspired by the Holy Spirit to write the Bible. And it was true for them, and it's true for us now.
I love you. I am so thankful for each and every one of you, and I cannot wait to see you again. Right, I'll talk to you later. See you later. Bye.
I hope that you'll continue being safe and find out what your gifts and talents are and use them for God's glory. Until then, see you next time.
All right, Teen Kids, that was our year-end review mashup of all the videos that we've seen this year. Just wanted to let you know how much we love you and we miss you. We're looking forward to seeing you in person soon. Maybe the weather will clear up and we can get outside and go do something all together one day. That'd be really, really fun. Until then, keep looking every week for these videos. Miss Janine?
Hi, guys. Hey. Bye, guys. I'm going to miss you these next couple of weeks. But, you know, to be safe, I guess it probably is best. But don't forget, there's many ways that you can watch our videos. We're not forgetting about you, so don't forget about us, okay? I love y'all. See you soon.
Thank you, Mr. Mia. Miss Lacey?
Hey, boys and girls. It's been a really long time since I've seen all of you in person. And when I just look back and think about all the times that I did have together with you guys in person, I just miss your smiling faces and your hugs. And I really pray that all this stuff will be over soon and we can get back together again. But until then, just keep watching the videos and just keep seeking Jesus and who he is and praying, obeying, and studying his word every day.
All right. That's what I was going to say, Miss Lacey. I was going to say, wear your mask, wash your hands, wash your distance, and worship the Lord by studying that Teen Kid Bible every single week. All right, y'all have a great week. Bye. We love you. We miss you.